Israel's defense establishment has unveiled a laser-based system on Wednesday. The system is designed to provide protection from different kinds of projectiles, like unguided rockets that are launched against Israel by knocking them out of the air. The new system will complement the country's existing layered air defense, which consists of several air defense systems like Iron Dome and Arrow. As per reports, the new system will undergo testing in the coming months and is likely to be operational within a year and a half. Laser-based systems are being developed by several countries and are seen as a future of air defense. In this video, Defense Updates reports on Israel unveiling of laser-based interception system. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by War Thunder. If you are, like us, fascinated by military vehicles and technology, I recommend you give War Thunder a try. It's a military vehicle combat game which you can download and play for free on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One with cross-platform support. It has a huge variety of more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s, which you can take to battle on land, in the air, and at sea on more than 80 theaters of war. War Thunder's been kind enough to offer all Defense Updates viewers a special bonus, which will grant you a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time for registering using our link in the description below. So take the plunge and join more than 20 million players from around the world. Israel has been targeted by different kinds of projectiles, like short-range rockets, artillery fire, and mortars. In the 1990s, Hezbollah, based in Lebanon, fired rockets into the northern part of Israel. This established a need for a system that could counter this threat. During the 2006 Second Lebanon War, the situation worsened. Hezbollah fired approximately 4,000 rockets, mostly the short-range Katyusha. The main targets of these rockets were the northern part of Israel, including Haifa, the country's third largest city. The rocket onslaught resulted in the deaths of 44 Israeli citizens. Not only this, approximately 250,000 Israeli citizens had to be evacuated, and an estimated 1 million Israelis were confined in or near bomb shelters during the assault. In the period between 2000 and 2008, 8,000 projectiles were launched in the southern part of Israel, mainly by Hamas. It's estimated that 50% of these were rockets and the other 50% were mortar bombs. The rockets were mostly Qassams launched by 122mm Grad launchers from Gaza Strip. The Qassam has a longer range than previous rockets, and almost 1 million civilians were within its range. This increased Israel's determination to find a solution to this security challenge, and this led to the work on counter-rocket, artillery, and mortar, or CRAM, solution. In 2007, after a lot of evaluations, Israel's defense minister, Amir Peretz, selected Iron Dome for defense against short-range threats. In 2011, Israel began operating the Iron Dome officially. According to Israel, it's been used to intercept more than 1,500 targets, with a greater than 90% success rate since it was deployed in 2011, though the data regarding the success rate is often challenged by critics. The possible introduction of the laser-based system will see it being used along with the Iron Dome. The new system was made public by the head of the Defense Ministry's Weapons Development Administration, Brigadier General Yaniv Rotem. He said, "We are entering a new era of energy combat in the air, on land, and at sea. Investments by the Defense Ministry in recent years have positioned Israel among the leading countries in the field of high-power lasers. As per reports, Israel has actually been working on high-power laser technology for years. But significant progress has been made in a collaborative effort involving Israel's defense ministry, Israel defense firms, Rafael Advanced Defense Systems, Elbit Systems, and members of their academic community. The system is based on electric laser technology, unlike chemical-based lasers, which have been developed earlier. Reports indicate that a breakthrough in the Israeli effort came about a year and a half ago. The Israeli team of scientists and engineers were able to create a technology to focus and stabilize the laser beams over distances and overcoming atmospheric disturbances. This led to the development of effective interception technology. Lasers are concentrated beams of light that transmit large amounts of electromagnetic radiation against their targets. The power of a laser is generally stated in kilowatts. The general idea of laser beam weaponry is to hit a target with a train of brief pulses of light. The rapid evaporation and expansion of the surface cause shock waves that damage the target. When a laser beam strikes a target, it can cause the external surface to heat up rapidly. This can cause a drone or a rocket or a shell to burst in the sky. Lasers have some very important advantages. The speed of light enables them to hit their targets almost instantaneously. Laser weapons also don't need to carry ammunition like traditional systems, and hence they'll be able to take out a much larger number of threats, constrained only by the power supply limit of the platform. This is pretty significant, as traditional air defense systems can run out of ammunition when encountering a large number of incoming threats. They're silent and invisible, which makes them very much suitable for use in the urban landscape. They're also so much cheaper. The new system could cost as low as $3.50 per interception. This is very cost-effective compared to conventional weapons. For example, Iron Dome cost $49,000 per interception. An FIM-92 Stinger short-range shoulder-fired surface-to-air missile has a price of $38,000, and a Patriot surface-to-air missile costs around $1 million each. Lasers do have their own issues. They're susceptible to weather conditions, since they rely on optics in order to successfully hit the intended target. But as the technology matures, there's no reason to believe these challenges can't be overcome by targeted effort. Israel's expertise in developing air defense system is well known, and even the US Army had finalized a deal to bring Israel's Iron Dome to the United States last year. The idea is to utilize Iron Dome to protect against cruise missiles. Viewers can check the video on the above card to know more about that. The Israeli Defense Ministry stated, "If we successfully attach the system to an aircraft, we could overcome the hurdle of unexpected weather. We could potentially intercept rocket fire right above the enemy's heads." Defense Minister Naftali Bennett stated, "The Israeli mind keeps paving the way. The new laser project will turn Israel's defense into deadlier and more advanced. It's a clear message to our enemies. Our capabilities are vast." America's been working with lasers for some time now, and even experimentally deployed them on warships. These systems, as of now, are only capable of taking out relatively easy targets, like small boats, and that too at short ranges. The Israeli system appears to be a class above, and if it works as stated, it will be a quantum leap. A system like this could potentially be installed in land, sea, and air platforms in the future. Apart from acting as a counter-rocket, artillery, and mortar solution, the system could be possibly used against drone swarms and hypersonic weapons going forward. Drone swarms will be like a dense cloud, and this makes it hard for the air defense system to properly track and target any single drone out of these. Also, most current air defense systems will run out of ammunition. Hypersonic weapons can travel at speeds of more than Mach 5, that's 5 times the speed of sound. Unlike subsonic and supersonic weapons, hypersonic weapons currently have no counters, and a laser-based system could be the answer to this.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.